Trademark goods and services. Let's talk about this. Hi, my name is Martis. I make daily video about business, legal, and intellectual property. What is intellectual property? Think about copyright, trademark, or other intellectual property. In this video, we want to talk about trademark goods and services. For what kind of goods or services can you register a trademark? I want to show you where you can see that. I want to also show you what kind of website you can use when you look at those kind of things. But let's look at the drawing board, and it's important that you know some things about trademark. When you register a trademark, it can be a word mark or an image, or an image in combination with a word mark, or other things. I show you some examples of trademark in another video, but I'm just going to discuss these two. Yeah. When you register a trademark, when you get a register a trademark, you will get a trademark for a server or service or good. It can be anything. I will show you some example later, but that means that when you have a trademark, for example, for shoes, when someone uses your trademark in combination with the shoe, you can sue them. There are some exception or other things. I'm not going to discuss that here, but I'm just giving you that example. And what you need to remember is when you have a trademark, you always have it in combination with something. That's why it's important when they describe the services of the goods in the trademark. That's really important that you describe exactly what kind of services of goods the trademark is for. Because you always have to keep in mind when you create a brand, who are your customer and what kind of brand are you creating? What is the good? What kind of services? What kind of brand are you creating for what kind of services? Example, Apple. Products and sometimes some services. When you look up the trademark Apple, you see clearly what kind of services or what kind of product the name Apple or MacBook people will use the term for. And if you look at Apple, I will talk about that in another video, but Apple has a guideline how you are allowed to use their trademark. If you do not follow that guideline, they can sue you. So what are the goods and how can you find the list of the goods for trademark? Thing is, it's not that every country has a different list of goods. Most of the time it's just the same. The class is the same. If they're connected to the WIPO, it's the same. So I'm gonna go look at the list in Europe. Technically it's the same as the US, Australia, New Zealand. Doesn't matter. Yeah? So let's look at, so in Europe we have wepo.europe.eu. So we're gonna go to that website. And when you're at the website, you get some information about trademark, design, and all intellectual property, just intellectual property in Europe. But we are here to get the list of the goods. Sometimes online is difficult to find, but you can Google it, but I'm just showing you where you can get it. Here, you just go to goods and services. And when you go down, you see nice classification. So you can press that. Come to this article and you go to TM class. In another video, I'll explain to you what this is. This is technically database where you can search what kind of trademark there are. But we're gonna go to that website because you see here, you have a different URL than this one. Okay? And when you come here, you come to the database and you see every country that's connected, and when you search the trademark, you can find whatever you need. So you see here, trademark office, Australia, US, New Zealand, you see all of them here. And you can look one trademark in all of those databases. So we are here to look for the goods and services. What are they? So if you hear classification resources, you press nice class headings, and then you have the classification, you can print it out. And let's show you what I mean by classification. You see here, it changed sometimes, so watch out which edition you are using. You see class 1 until 45, I think it's 45. Yeah, 45. You have 45 classes. When you register a trademark, it can be a trademark for number 5, number 6. It doesn't matter. It depends how much you pay for it. Most of the time, you pay for 1 class, 3 class, or 5 class. It doesn't matter. It depends how you're planning to build your brand. If you're registering trademark, it's important to build a strategy. How you're going to register and what kind of class are you going to use it. And it also depends on your product. So for example, if I have an, let's say, a brand and I want to register a trademark for it, for let's say oil, essential oil, I can use 3 and this. Nike or Philips is a good example, use 35 if I'm correct. Yeah, advertising, business manager, business administration, but they also use other classes. Yeah. And then you have shoes. So what you can do is you can control find as shoes. Let's say sports, transportable. You can see you have a lot of transport. Yeah, sporting articles. So if you look at Nike or Adidas, most of them are here, 28. So when they register trademark, they are 29 or 28. It depends what this, by the way, not 29, 28. Because 29 is about food, if I'm correct. Yeah. Yeah, I cannot name brands that are in here. Some Unilever can be in here, milk, Unilever. And coffee, espresso can also be here for the name, the espresso. And I cannot name a lot of brands in here, but education, providing, entertainment is what. Nike can also be in here, but I'm going to show you some examples so you can see. So this is the classification. Let's look some trademark up. So when you go here, you see some trademark examples. I talk about this in another video. And let's say we have Adidas. And you see, I think Adidas is a Spanish company, original, but I'm not sure. Yeah. But you see, it's loading the trademark application. So when they apply for a trademark, they fill the application. And if they get it, you see the whole process and application in here. So let's go down. You see here, yeah, Adidas is 35. Nice classification. That means this. Go to 35. Advertising, business management, business administration, office functions. So if you look here, you see retail service in field of footwear, clothing, and sport articles. Sometimes the description of the product may be different from this. This just means they make a clear description of their products or services, in this case services. You can do that. And sometimes the office, the IP office, can be difficult about that, but most of the time they're okay with it if you give a clear definition of the product. So if you look another one as an example, so we talk about Adidas, let's look at Philips. Philips is a big company. They do a lot, especially in the technical area. And if you look at the trademark, they have more than one classification. What does this mean? When you register a trademark, you do not, you're allowed to choose more classes. But the thing is, it can be expensive. If you register 10 classes at the same time, you can get a trademark, but it can be really expensive. So you see here, you have Philips. Here, it's a Dutch company. Originally is Dutch. They filed in Dutch in 1996. You see here, they have a lot of classification, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and so on. And they can do that. I think they pay a lot for it, and they use it also. Because the thing is, if you register for a class and you do not use it, you can lose your trademark for that. So if I register for 14 and if I don't use it, if someone say, hey, you don't use it for that, you can lose it. Yeah. That's the whole process behind that. I'm going to talk about that in another video. But here, I just want to show you, you have different classes. When you register a trademark, this is a word trademark, like we saw. and they were excited for these kind of for these classes. And one more thing, getting a world trademark, it can be difficult, but Philips is unique. So you see here how they write it down, so it can be unique. And here, figurative mark is just an image, and it's easy to get a trademark for it. You can also make a combination of it, but I will also make another video about that, how you can use it, these tactics to get whatever you want. So yeah, this is the classification. You can download it. I show you how you can get it here to this page. You can download, look at it, and if you have questions about it, feel free to ask me. If you're new to this channel, feel free to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.